Hi guys, so welcome to my channel. My name is Lindsay and I just want to say thanks for coming, checking out this workout video here. So today's workout, what I have planned for us is just some upper body and it's gonna have a little bit of abs in there. There is no cardio, but I will say that it is a sweaty workout and this would be a great one to pair with another sort of cardio, like whether it's a bike ride or jumping on, you know, a treadmill or elliptical. So I, this month with the videos, I just really have tried to do a lot of upper body focus. So I hope you guys are loving this. And today's weight, I just have some light dumbbells. There is a single arm row that I'm going to use two for. But if you have some heavier weight that you wanna use for a row, okay, you could have that close by. But for the majority of the workout, all you need is some light weight. So we're gonna start here with some walkouts here just to get the body kind of loosened up. And we're gonna wake up the arms, the legs, the abs, and start to break a little bit of a sweat. So you guys, try this with me, and then if you need to like change up any of the moves, okay, go for it for sure. But let's have some fun here. So go ahead and hinge down. Let's touch our toes. Let's walk out to the end here. Little pause in that plank, and then let's bring it right back up. Walk the hands in towards the feet, and then you can stand up and you can reach up nice and high. So we're gonna stay here for about 45 seconds here, walking out to the end, little stretch there. And then you're gonna push right back up, walking those hands in, touch the toes, touch the ceiling. We are hitting shoulders, we're hitting core, we're hitting the hamstrings and the triceps. So I love this. Okay, we've got about 25 more seconds. Walk it out, walk it in, and then reach high. 15 seconds. We're gonna do two more, okay? Give me two more. Whew. Last one here. And then we're gonna get right into our workout. So what we're gonna do, you guys, is gonna go ahead and go to grab the weights, and then we're gonna start actually on the floor here. I'm gonna do a kneeling position, and if you need to do this on your toes, you can totally stand up and do this. And here's what's happening. It doesn't really matter what leg you have up. I'm just gonna go ahead and put my right leg up or my left leg up there. If you wanna mirror me, that would be fine as well. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go for a bicep curl. So right here, I'm gonna keep my elbows kind of locked into the body. I'm on a slight lean. Okay, I'm gonna add a bicep curl there and then I'm gonna raise those weights in the front. So you can see my palms are facing out the whole time. All right, so we're gonna start here. Okay, nice bicep curl right there. And then you're gonna extend the arms and then raise them like eye level. So we squeeze and then we raise. So palms face out. So this is why the weights need to be a little bit light, okay? The biceps are definitely getting some work here, some shoulders and some back. And you're getting a little bit of core here. By being in this kneeling position here, we take the legs pretty much out of it and we use a lot of the core to stabilize us, right? Tight curl. Raise it in front right there. So let's go 15 more seconds, squeeze, and then raise. All right, squeeze, and then raise. On your bicep curl, check those elbows. Keep them close to your body. Open it back up, raise. Six, five, four. We're gonna do one more. Three, two, and one. Awesome, right? Okay, so now we're gonna come up to our feet. I'm gonna stick with this lighter weight here. We're going to do a bent raise, and then I'm gonna kind of circle my weights back here. So you're gonna hinge at the hip here, nice flat back, okay? Core nice and tight. We're gonna raise the weights, and then I'm gonna circle behind me here, bring it right back up, and then back down to my starting position. So you want that back flat, raise them, circle them back, bring them together, and down. So right here, when you pull those weights back, you wanna kind of squeeze your blades back. Okay, it's similar to what we've done before, okay, when we are in kind of like a Superman position. You wanna feel those same upper back muscles. Circle back, bring them together. Now if you need to, you can always stand up, reset yourself, and then go right back down. If you feel anything in that lower back, okay, anything that doesn't feel right, you guys, then you need to take the weight down or you need to modify the move entirely, all right? Or you can do this with no weight. You can do this with water bottles. So challenging for the core, yeah, definitely shoulders and that upper back, okay? We're squeezing, You're gonna give me a few more seconds here. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and time. And then it'll feel good to stand up right there. Awesome. Okay, so now we're gonna go down into a bear and we're gonna do a tricep extension here. So the easiest way to get set up is to go into your tabletop position here. And then if you want to, you lift those knees up off the floor. So we're gonna row and then we're gonna extend into that tricep extension there. And then you're gonna return it. So row, out, back in, and down. And just keep those dumbbells right under your shoulders. You wanna keep that back flat, bottom down. My feet are hip distance apart. And I'm trying to really keep my body stable and my abs tight, okay? Up, out, back in, and down. So you're gonna get some biceps here too, okay? Along with your back, your triceps, shoulders, legs, and core. And you just keep repeating right here. You got about 15 seconds. Core tight, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and time. Okay, go ahead and stand up, kind of shake yourself out a little bit here, and then we're going into some rows next. So I'm gonna grab weight. What I'm gonna do here, I think, is kind of double up. So since I don't have a heavy dumbbell here, I'm gonna use two for the row, and then I'm gonna do one side and we'll do the other side. So if you need to, you guys, use two weights, or if you have one, okay, go ahead and grab that. So basically I'm gonna put myself on a lean here, right? If you have a chair, you can hold the back of a chair, but you wanna be, again, strong through your core, okay? I'm kinda turned to the side here so you guys can see here. So I'm flat back right there and I'm not letting my shoulder round forward. I'm just gonna target this one side right here, okay? Drive that elbow right along the side of the body. Up and back, okay? You wanna keep strong through your legs, and I would just keep my eyes up a little bit in front of my toes there so you're not straining your neck too much, okay? Or looking too far down. Okay, we're here on each arm for about 30 seconds, so whew, breathe, feeling good. Super nice upper back work. Let's go 15 more seconds, and then we'll just switch sides, okay? Drive that elbow up high. Good, 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then we switch. And go ahead and stand up. You can pass your weight or your weights over, right, to the other side. All right, here we go. Nice flat back. Okay, I've got my feet staggered, and then I'm just gonna slide that elbow right there, up and back. It's almost like your weights are coming to that hip right there, right? And you can see I'm not letting the shoulder move. Just really nice controlled rows. Whew. Already burning, so good. So good. Get that elbow up nice and high. 15 seconds. Awesome, right? So good. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and there you have it. So we're gonna go down to the floor. Now I'm going to do some plank jump-ins. I'm gonna continue using my little heavier set of weights there, and I'm going to plank off of them, and I'm just gonna jump my feet in and out here. You can walk them in and out. We've done something similar to this before. And then I'm gonna roll right over onto my back and I'm gonna do a pullover with a skull crusher combo. And then we'll be back to the top, right? So follow me here. If you can do this off of your weights, that's great. If you wanna do it entirely, okay, off of the floor, that's fine as well. So look, all I'm doing is jumping in here and then jumping back out. Jumping in, jumping back out. Now you can walk, right? You can step in, but step or jump on the outside of your hands. And you're here for about 30 seconds. A little cardio, a little core. little arm. I'm feeling my back. Go at your own pace. I'm kind of going kind of steady here, not too fast, but not too slow. 12, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and time. And then like I said, I'm just gonna come right over onto my back here. So I'm gonna do a skull crusher with a pullover, and I'm gonna add legs with it, all right? So it's gonna look like this. You guys are gonna come down, nice flat back. So you've got your weights up here. So you're gonna hinge right here, and then you're gonna come up and hit that tricep, then you're gonna pull over and come up, and then you're gonna reset, okay? Tricep, squeeze, pull over, squeeze, and then reset. Hinge right there with that tricep, hit that toe, pull it over, hit that toe. Okay, we take our time right here because we've got a couple things going on here, right? Hit that leg up for that tricep, then pull it over right there. Let's repeat that. Hinge right here. Now bring that leg up. Yep, now straighten your arms out, go over, and then meet the other leg up right there. Plenty of time here. You can soften the elbows a little bit on the pullover. You can leave the legs out entirely if you just want to do that skull crush with a pullover. That'd be nice to add a little bit of core here. Take your time. Press high. Okay, we're here. Let's take it another maybe 20 seconds, right? Because it's such a good thing. It's two things, three things in one. Right, right here. Tip, hinge to the forehead, bend the elbows. Now come up, meet the toe. Now go straight arm over, and then meet the other toe. All right, let's try about three more sets. Tricep, right there. Pull over, right there. Do it again. Tricep, ooh! Pull over. Okay. Right, it takes a little bit of focus. Good stuff though, one more time here. Let's go. Skull crusher, come up, pull over, come up. And there you have it. Those are our moves. So we're gonna go right back to the top, you guys, since we're down on the floor. Okay, I've got that kneeling bicep with that raise, lighter weights. I'm back to my fives. Okay, again, you can use water bottles if you do not have super light weights. Okay, I'm putting my left leg up. Again, you pick what's best for you. You put yourself on a little bit of a lean. My palms are facing out. My shoulders are away from my ears. And here we go. We're gonna curl it, and then we're gonna raise it. So these are really nice, I feel like, fine-tuning moves, something a little different, okay, than like our normal, you know, bicep curl or our normal shoulder presses that we do a lot of. Okay, I just wanna spice it up a little bit with you guys. Okay, and give you something to really help sculpt the arms and the upper back. Okay, so good. With some core in here. So it doesn't need a lot of weight, which is great. You just use what you have. Woo! Right? Okay, squeeze and then bring them up. You're gonna have 15 more seconds right here. And then we're gonna stand up and I have that front raise with that back rotation. Let's go. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and there's your time. Okay, so we're gonna stand up. Again, light weight for this one. Okay, so my knuckles now, so before my palms were out, now my knuckles are out, all right? You're gonna go ahead, give yourself that shoulder roll. Nice flat back forward, okay? Hamstrings are engaged because a lot of my weight's in the legs there. So you're gonna come up, and then you're gonna just kind of circle back and down, and then meet right there again, and then back down to the thigh. So we up, we kind of circle back and down, engage the upper back, bring it here, and return it. Eyes in front of the toes, shoulders away from the ears. Good stuff. Right here. Oh, I love it. Remember what to do if you feel like you need a little relief, right? Go ahead, you stand up, and then you go right back down and start it again, right? Let's go. 15 seconds. We've got that tricep extension coming in our bear. Okay, next, put in a little more lean on it. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and there it is. Okay, come on down. So you can do this on the knees or you can come up off of the knees there just to give yourself a little more quad work and a little more challenge for the core. Okay, put your hands right under your shoulders, knees under the hips, okay, and my feet are hip distance apart, and we go. Row out to that tricep extension, back in, okay, back in right there, and then down. Let's do it. Think of your body like a machine, right? It's like a machine. So good, so good. 15 seconds, that's it. And then we're standing out for that single arm row, and that's your chance to go a little heavier, okay? If you've got the room to do it. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and time. Okay, we're coming up. Okay, gonna get my heavier weight. I'm gonna start with my right arm. So I put my left leg forward, my right leg back a little bit. I put it on my lean. Now, if you need a chair or something to hold on to, you guys totally grab that. I'm gonna use the top of my thigh here as a little base there. And then I want a flat back, not rounding the shoulders forward, driving that elbow up and back. Breathe, right? Breathe. Whew. Love this. Rowing that dumbbell up towards your hip right there. Okay, we're gonna be halfway already. You have 15 more seconds. Let's go. 15. Yes. 10, 9, come on. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, one more. And then we're gonna quickly switch. Go ahead and pass it. Okay, off to the other side. Set yourself up. All right. Here we go. 3, 2, let's do it. Focusing on the upper back. So a little bit of shoulder for sure, which I love. We're 10 in, starting in about 20 more seconds, and then we're hitting those jump ins, those plank jump ins. Okay, team 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Yes. Okay, let's go. Down to the floor. Now I'm getting sweaty, which I love. And then I have that little combo for us. We'll spend almost a minute on that tricep. All right, so let's get our heart rate up here. Hands under the shoulders. Start out in a plank position. And then you're just jumping in nice and wide. And then back out. On or off of the weights, jumping or stepping, your best pace. 20 seconds. Whew. Legs are burning, so good, so good. Come on, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, come on over. Okay, I'm staying with a little heavier weights here. Lay it on back. All right, think long body, lower back, lift to the floor, weights come together. Okay, and first thing we do, we hinge to the elbow, right? Elbow to wrist to the forehead here, and then go ahead and press yourself out, and then pull over, and then press yourself up right there. All right, I just kind of got to get into my rhythm here. See, one there, and then one there, okay? And then start it over. One there, one there. Woo! Love it. Watch those elbows. So good. So about 15 seconds in, we should be getting in our groove now on the second set. up with those shoulders, and then over to the toe, and then restart. There's like a slight pause there, right after that pullover. Get yourself back there where you need to be. 30 seconds to go, and then we are back through it one more time. Squeeze, over. I love this. 20 seconds. This. Go ahead and grab those smaller dumbbells. Start kneeling if it's best for you. I will switch sides. This time I'll put my right leg up. Right. Okay, just a little lean here. Elbows locked into my body. And I'm going to go curl it. And then I'm going to raise it right there. Right. Little lean on it. Feeling getting stronger and stronger with these arms. Hope you guys are loving these upper body focused workouts recently. Okay, go back and comment or, you know, save your favorites. This would be a great one to do when you don't have a lot of time or if you don't have a lot of weight available. You have just, like I said, you can even use it, literally anything, right? Water bottles, cans, wine bottles. Okay, squeeze. Let's go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. We might as well finish. One more raise here in the front. And there it is. Okay, I'm going to stand up. To me, this is the challenging one, right? Whew. So, check your feet out. Roll your shoulders. Hinge down so you've got the knuckles facing out. Right here, so we're going up, and then we're kind of circling back and down, and then bring it right back up. So it's like you've got a cable pull right there. Imagine having like a set of cables, right? We pull the cables down, we return them, and then we can kind of come out and back with them. So if you're in the gym, this would be, you know, another great thing you could do. You could grab the cables and incorporate this into your video right now, right? Pull it back. Another thing, if we had bands, this would be a great move with some bands. You've got 12 seconds, come on. Let's go a little lower on the lean. Right here, pull them back, return them. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and done. Okay, we're going back to that bear with that tricep. Okay, set it up. Here we go, 3, 2, let's do it. Don't swing your weight, row first, and then take it out from the elbow to the wrist. Okay, row, extend, bring it back in and down.
Providing weight, but think of your back, okay? Think of your back, open up the chest, give me about 12 more seconds on these rows, and then we'll switch sides. Come on, elbow goes high. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, woo, 2, 1, and then we switch. All right, other side, pass it off, set yourself up, and when you're ready, we go 3, 2, let's do it. All right, drive it high, up and back. So good, okay? We are so close. So we're gonna come down, we're going to that plank next, right? We just finished with those last two moves on the floor, and you guys should feel really good there through your arms and your upper back, right? I promise you, you'll feel some of this tomorrow. Okay, let's go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, let's go. On or off of your weights, you guys. We're in the home stretch now, right under 2 minutes. All right, let's finish this. Set your weights. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, and let's do it. I might give you a forearm plank here on the end just to kind of tie it all in together. So out, in, let's go. Out, in. Little cardio, little core. Okay, 15 seconds, let's go. 15. Good, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay. What we could do to save a little bit of time and to just really finish off those triceps and those lats is let's do one side at a time, okay? So let's start with all skull crushers and let's do one leg, okay? So let's say all skull crushers, right leg first, okay? We ready? Okay, here we go. We're up in that skull crusher position. Okay, we're gonna go right here. Right leg, okay, and then let's switch in left leg, all right? We should alternate, that'll be just better, right here. Okay. We'll go pullovers next. So we'll do about 30 seconds on these skull crushers, and then we'll do 30 seconds on those pullovers, and then we'll finish in a forearm plank, all right? Hinge, press it out, right? Hinge, press it out. I like to bring my shoulders up with it, but think about keeping the lower back glued to the floor. Come on, 15 seconds, let's go. 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now we switch to the pullover, okay? You can use one or two weights for this. Go over and then up. Over and then up, right there. Nice and easy. Okay, soften up your elbow a little bit. Stretch it out. I like to go with it, right? Taking my shoulders up, just like I did on that skull crush. Come on, 20 seconds. We flip, squeeze. Crunch those abs hard, 15. Crunch them, come on, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, okay, quickly, okay, come on over, forearm plank and we're done. You can modify this on the knees, however you can do this best, but just really think about your upper back while we're down here. Elbows are right under, okay? Right under my shoulders. And I'm super strong. Head to heel, straight line. Okay, so we're just gonna hold here for about 40 seconds. Okay, take the glutes, tighten the glutes up. Hamstrings should be engaged. Definitely the core and the back. I want you to focus on that other back right here, okay? Kind of round your upper back. 15 seconds in, so I need 25 more. Okay, guys, great job today. I hope you loved it, okay? I left some of the cardio and the impact out, and I thought this would be really nice. Again, fine-tuning, really upper body focused. Okay, we got 15 seconds, squeeze. 15, as tight as you can now, tight as you can. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and time. All right, good work, gang. Thank you so much. I hope you loved it. Get outside or inside. Any way you can get the cardio done, you can pair this, okay? Even if it's a 15-minute fast walk outside, or if you have a stationary bike or an outdoor bike, I challenge you guys, get some cardio in with this one. Like, subscribe, share, and just continue to stay on top of your workouts. And I appreciate you guys, love you guys, and have an awesome rest of your day. All right, see you soon.